Hi there. Have you ever taken a balloon and rubbed it on your head like this to get your hair to stick up? Yeah, it's called static electricity. Well, let's try something out and see if we can't learn something about it. So I have two regular balloons. I'm gonna rub them together. Let's see what happens. All right, looks like they're a little bit sticky, but not too much. Let's go ahead and add in another material. This here is some rabbit fur. I'm gonna rub this on these balloons and let's see what happens. Huh, now these balloons aren't even getting anywhere near each other. Why do you think that is? Yeah, it's that static electricity again. When we rubbed the fur on these balloons, we transferred some charge. And now that these balloons have the same charge, they repel each other. Well, let's introduce a third material. This here is some PVC pipe. I'm gonna rub it with the fur, and I'm gonna have you hold it up to the balloons and see what happens. Huh. Yeah, the balloons aren't attracted to this pipe either. They seem to be repelled by it. Well, that means that this pipe must have the same charge as these balloons. Let's see what happens when we put the piece of fur up here. Yeah, the fur is able to attract the balloons. That means that the fur and the balloons must have opposite charges. Well, scientists at the University of Wisconsin are able to use this static electricity to generate new power sources. And they have a special name for this type of static electricity. They call it triboelectricity. And I have some triboelectric nanogenerators that I want you to play around with. So this first triboelectric nanogenerator we have is made from a plastic egg. On the inside, we've lined it with some aluminum foil, and we have a large super ball that we've wrapped in some Teflon tape. Maybe you've heard of Teflon for a nonstick coating on your pots and pans. And then coming out of this egg, we have some wires that are attached to a light-emitting diode, an LED. So what I want you to do, I want you to take this egg and I want you to shake it and tell me what you see. Yeah, the light in here is lighting up. So these triboelectric nanogenerators allow us to harvest the energy of motion. There's a lot of different ways we can do this. So another way we can do it is with this little guy here. So this triboelectric nanogenerator is made out of two pieces of paper. On one piece of paper, I wrapped it in that same Teflon tape, and I wanted to hook some wires up to it, so I coated the backs of them with pencil graphite. Pencil graphite's able to conduct electricity, so that'll allow us to get the current to flow. And the wire's hooked up to another LED, so why don't you look inside this peephole and tap on this nanogenerator and tell me what you see. Yeah, the light's lighting up again. So there's a lot of really cool uses for these triboelectric nanogenerators. Some things are really hard to replace the battery for, like pacemakers. So scientists can implant these triboelectric nanogenerators into a pacemaker, so that way they don't need a battery. You can also put it in floorings of different buildings, so that way every step someone takes is powering electricity for the building. And if you create large networks of these nanogenerators, you can harvest the energy of the ocean.